In this video, we're going to discuss the internal process perspective of the balanced scorecard. So what do we even mean by internal process? What are we talking about here? Well, if you think about it, every single company has certain internal processes, certain activities that the company has to do very, very well in order to remain competitive. So if you think about like McDonald's or some fast food restaurant, you're going to think about speed. A customer does not want to walk into a McDonald's and wait 20 to 30 minutes for their order. It has to be fast. They want to walk in, get their order, walk out. So the time to serving a customer would be an internal process that would be very important to a fast food restaurant. So every company should always be striving and trying harder and harder to improve those internal processes, those activities that it needs to deliver on. And so it could be thinking about some of the following questions. You could think about, well, what are our processes that we need to excel at? Again, it depends on the industry, depends on the company. As I said, fast food would be speed. If we think about a company like UPS, they're a delivery company. So we're going to think about the percentage of on-time deliveries. They need to make sure that if they say it's going to be there by 11 a.m. the next day, it's going to be there by 11 a.m. So the percentage of on-time deliveries would be very important to a company like that. If you think about a manufacturing company and we think about what processes do they need to excel at and how would they know if they're mastering those processes, we could think about quality. We think about product quality because you're actually building your product. And so we could measure that with defect rates. And if you say, okay, well, every time we make 100 products, we have one that's defective. Well, that's a problem. That's a 1% defect rate. That's very high. And you might think about how do we get it to where it's one every 10,000 or one every 20,000 or 100,000 and so forth. You constantly want to be improving those processes because if you're not, one of your competitors is going to deliver a better defect rate and say, hey, we are going to provide a higher quality product and you're going to be out of business. And then you also need to be thinking about it constantly coming up with new processes, re-engineering your existing processes to get better. And that comes back to when we think about our learning and growth perspective that we started with. We come up with new ideas, we're constantly getting better, but then we have to translate those into better processes. We have to turn around and say, okay, we've got these ideas. Maybe our employees came up with a really good idea. How do we turn that into actually re-engineering our processes or coming up with a new process in order to implement that? Okay, so it's not just coming up with the idea. We did the learning, we did the growth. Now, how do we translate that into action? How do we actually improve the way we run our business? How do we actually get more on-time deliveries? How do we actually say that we're going to get more sales from new products, that we're going to get more patents? If we think about a drug company, we say, okay, we want to come up with new ideas and so forth with the learning and growth. Okay, how do we actually turn that into more patents? Okay, and then if we think about in terms of a company that's like a retailer, online retail, what about the amount of seconds that it takes to respond to a customer's inquiry or the amount of minutes and so forth? So how are we always improving those processes? How are we getting better? And if you come back to an example we talked about in a previous video or where we put together a balanced scorecard for a fictional online retailer, here's where the internal processes, it comes into this approach. So we started with our learning and growth, and we just said in this example that we're going to focus on investing in employee training and employee satisfaction. We really wanted, with our learning, to build the capabilities of our employees, and we were hoping we would reduce employee turnover. And we also talked about, you know, if the employees are happier, that'll lead to them being more productive and so forth. Now, if we do this, if we actually succeed, we are assuming that there's going to be a cause and effect relationship, that this is going to lead to better processes. And we have defined internal process in this fictional example. We said we wanted to provide prompt, informative responses to customer inquiries. So we're an online retailer. We might get emails and stuff from customers or questions, and we wanted to respond quickly with a good answer to people. Okay, we didn't want people waiting 2 days before they receive an email back from us. And so we want to measure that in terms of our time to response. So again, we start with, all right, our learning and growth. How are we, what are we going to do? Well, we're gonna make our employees better. We're gonna spend the time necessary to help them. We're gonna make them happier. We're gonna train them to be more knowledgeable. They're not gonna be as likely to quit. They're gonna stay with the company longer. And as a result, our processes are gonna improve. It's not gonna take 2 days for people to receive a response. Now they're gonna receive a response within 10 minutes because our employees are staying with us. They're learning, they're getting better. And so they're gonna be able to respond faster. They're gonna be better at this. And that's gonna map into, we're gonna have better processes. They're ultimately gonna make our customers happier. And we're gonna talk about the customer perspective in the next video.